Oops. Ooh. Yeah. Torn sideways here. That was a huge rock. I just moved. Oops. You can see it. Yeah. Those are my issues right now.
Adventure ride first. That's going to be Rick's ride, and they're going up to Iron Chest. Iron Chest starts with about what, a half a mile?
We'll call it black. Maybe double black diamond for that first half mile.
Yeah. So you're driving on basketballs mixed with Volkswagen rocks. But the reward is getting beyond that first half mile and getting up high on the slopes and up into the mining country and the views that you get from up on top. It, absolutely grand. So it is, from a scenery standpoint, it's one of the best rides around. Getting there is the challenge. Let's get the Jeeps lined up. Let's go, Jeepers!
Put my feet on the thing. So look at my feet. Remember, I was doing fancy feet. It's just crawling right now. The EFI right there. First time up. I'll watch what I'm doing.
Ranger 1, we are all off of the road and at the parking area entering the trail.
Good copy.
Brandy low right now, give it a little bit of gas. Nice little crawl range right here. That's the the gatekeeper, I think. That's her. Gotta watch where I'm going. Way to go on these rocks. I was bad-mouthing yesterday at altitude, but I don't want to count my chickens before they hatch, but on that gatekeeper, boy, that was pretty nice. I did a couple obstacles at home, but you know, you got to travel to get this good stuff. What a sight that is. Look at that. Plates, bumpers, everything's getting kissed right now. A lot of love given from this trail. Take the long way around. diff. beautiful trees. Beautiful aspen, neon colors on this outstanding Iron Chest Trail. All these rockosauruses around us, under us.
through it. Laughing. That's awesome. Beer commercials right there. Man, I don't want this to stop. Keep climbing. I see the clearing coming up. Goodness, what a view, spectacular. In the 12.2 or 12.5 yesterday, 10 cup pass, definitely didn't like 12.5, stalled out on me. We're climbing up pretty good above tree lines, so that should probably be about the 12 somewhere, but we'll see how it goes. Definitely got some huge points on that rock crawl right now. It was like on my end as far as effortlessly. I wasn't fighting the carburetor or anything. I was just enjoying myself.
Well,
up again. EFI don't like the altitude. For whatever reason. So I took up the hood. Took off the air cleaner.
And let me breathe.
So I'm hanging out the side of my Jeep right now. So I can see. Otherwise, we're looking like that. Can you see it? Anyhow, those are my issues right now. 12,000 feet. Temperature's what?
190.
190?
It was 190.
Okay. So I don't think it's... Well, I don't know. I don't know what it is. All I know, that gets me going again. Gotta be an air problem, probably oxygen deprived. Probably gotta get a new air cleaner or something like that. I don't know. That's my guess today. Get it up to a flat area right here, and I'll put the hood back down. Maybe that's what it needs. You know, I'm not real familiar with these EFIs. So, could be. Anyway, I'm gonna run it with the air cleaner off and we'll give it a go. Alright, party on, Garth.
Party on, Wayne.
Swing! Again, there's that nice cabin. Looks like Stan's having trouble too up there. like we're having ourselves a vapor log party. So yeah, this time we got up to 190. Maybe that's the problem. I don't know. I got like 4 or 5 inches from my exhaust and my fuel line, so I don't exactly know what's happening.
Hello.
Good job.
We can do it. We'll do it.
We'll find a way.
That's it. We'll find a way.
We'll find a way.
I'm guessing it's air. I mean, I measured the fuel lines away from the exhaust there, and I got like almost, that's like 5 inches. That's how much I put it up in there. So that shouldn't be the ants. That shouldn't be why. But I mean, I don't know. We shall see. Oops. Got a little too happy there. My EFI is back in its battle zone. It's happy and it's just kicking butt right now. I'm just letting it idle. Going right over. I don't have to fight with the carb, hit the brake, hit the clutch, accelerate pedal, back and forth with your feet. That's EFI still winning. Even though I'm mad at it for breaking down it above the tree line where there's no oxygen. Well, I'll figure it out. I think this was easier going up. Give a little gas. gatekeeper. We're going back down it, off to the road. I'm in granny low right now. I might switch to one, I'm not sure. Zilla's here. Everybody wants to reach out and touch us. Ooh. Sideways here. Wow, that was a huge rock. I just moved. Moving us. We got off it. That's why I built skid plates. If I didn't have a skid plate, that would have tore us up. I should have took your door off, huh? Carnage. Getting tired? Nope. Okay. Tell you what, boys, the EFI, this is where it makes its money right here. I mean, I wish it was lower RPM, but I am happy with this result. rocks. I can't wait to go to Moab with this thing. Who put all these rocks here?
Man.
Stock Jeep right there. What is that thing? Guardhouse? They put a guardhouse down here? Doghouse?
It's probably somebody's house.
I think this is the hard line. I should have went zig when I was zagged. That was awesome. Dude, that was awesome.
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You bet. You got any damage?
I think you said you got a hickey here and here, maybe.
Oh, yeah, a little bit.
That's trail pride right there. That was awesome.
I survived if I had to go to the bathroom.
Well, it wasn't you. I wanted to be down there, but I just didn't know that we were that far back.
All right, comes the goat. There's the goat. All right, my man.